सब्सक्राइब करें और दबाएं इस बेल आइकॉन को सबसे पहले लेटेस्ट बॉलीवुड वीडियो देखने के लिए।
डिजाइनर ज्वेलरी एक मास्टरपीस कहलाते हैं। Having designed for some of the top Bollywood celebrities and people from India's foremost business families, she insists on being a perfectionist. We are glad to transforming the image of PNG to a professionally run corporate entity with global ambitions. A huge round of applause for him, ladies and gentlemen.
That was just a presentation of what we are as a brand. I want to tell you a little bit about myself. I come from a non-jewelry background. I started my journey in 1993, 25 years ago. I launched my brand Farah Khan in the year 2004, 14 years ago. I've always believed in doing whatever I wanted to with all my heart, with all passion, and the best of what I love to do. So I've always done it right. My jewelry is unique. It's people tell me it's beautiful, it's unusual, it's different. And I think it comes because I create with lots and lots of love. I put a lot of myself into the product. What we as a brand can offer you is unusual designs, great finish, really great finish, because our finish is compared to international brands. As a brand myself, my market is not just India. I have a lot of international clients who buy from me, so I keep that in mind when I make jewelry. I've also had the privilege of visiting 40 different cities in India and interacting with customers on ground level to understand their needs and to design according to their likes. And right from the north to the south, to the east and the west, I've actually traveled to the remotest areas, like Bilaspur, I mean, just to give you a name, you know, Indore, Nasik, Guwahati. I mean, you name those places, basically. So as a designer, I have a pulse of the Indian market, but at the same time, I can also create designs that are very, for the millennials. So I can do traditional jewelry, I can do jewelry that is also catered to your millennial. But what I do bring in all of this is I listen to my customer and I bring a lot of me into my product. So that's what I can offer each one of you here. In the end, to sum it up, I'd just like to say thank you to Bandhan Jewels for having me here. Prasad, Santosh, thank you. I look forward to this association and I look forward to meeting all of you. And we have some of our things displayed here, so please have a look. Thank you very much again. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Good evening. What do you want to hear from me? Anything specific? I mean, I was, that's why I asked Prasad right now. They're going to ask, someone's going to ask me what am I doing here, which is exactly what you asked. So, a couple of things. Prasad and we started Style Quotient some years ago, and this is an extended part of that. So, in that connection, I'm here. Secondly, Santosh has been a dear friend, and I believe in what he's doing. I think it's a great thing we're doing for industry right now. Santosh and Prasad met me on this concept 6 months ago, and we had a discussion on what exactly can be done here. And being a chain store, we discussed on what is good and what is not good for the industry. And point which they mentioned right now about stores being polarized now, or competition getting more and more intense, chain store having the mightier bit of it. So more marketing, more better purchase, better designing. So this is a very good concept. I think it's something which is the need of the hour today. And also industry is changing now. People today are open to collaborating, working together, because everyone is feeling the heat. Everyone is feeling that you no longer can work in the old style of being unorganized and doing their own things. Today the market's open, market's transparent, and consumers become more demanding. So I think it's a great platform, and I've really come there. I mean, though I'm definitely a part of it, but I really come to, you know, wish them. And I think it's a great concept. We have Farah, we have Vikram here, we have Krishna. So I think many more brands will join in. So it's a great concept. And it's something which I think will really help the retail and look at the size, the mid-size category spoke about. I think it's a great opportunity. And I personally feel that, you know, people should look at it. You know, you can have your own questions. You can have your... I think it's flexible. So a model can be something, like you said, it can be with a brand. It can be with your own brand. So try to make use of the expertise which Prasad has, which Santosh has, and the entire team has to offer. And as PNG, we wish you all the best. And, you know, I'm really sure that this will be a good success. And Salman Khan is also, right now he spoke about that. So I think Being Human has been a good brand. It's been last 2 years, and we have done good sales. It's gone international too. And, you know, it drives a lot of footfalls. Farah herself, you know, will drive a lot of footfall. Her designs are stunning. Vikram has a great range, Australian diamond. I think that whole concept of, you know, having everything for everybody, Kisna reaches the end of market. So this is like a well-packaged deal for all of you. So I think it's a very good opportunity. And I wish all of you the good luck. We all are part of industry, and let's all do well. And let's all have good days ahead. Thank you.
Saro, my question again to you, Saro here. Salman been your brand ambassador for years. Now Salman is coming with his own collection. So how will you be differentiated with two brands?
This was always there. Salman endorses PNG as a brand, and this is Salman's own brand. So Being Human Jewellery is a brand owned by Salman Khan, wherein Style Quotient does the designing, marketing, distribution and manufacturing. So this is Salman Khan's own brand. And PNG is something which Salman endorses. So they are two different things altogether. And Salman is not involved in designing at PNG, nor is he involved in selection here. So this is something which we do. And Salman promotes PNG. But Being Human is something which he and his family are deeply involved into. So the entire designing, the entire product, you know, what has to go in the market, pricing, it's all discussed along with him. So this is how they both are different. And we don't compete, because Salman, as PNG, it's more about the brand. And here is more of our products.
Actually, just to add to that, it was during the PNG, one of their shoots, because, you know, Salman being the brand ambassador, that's where we actually spoke to him about Bajrangi Bhaijaan at that point in time, whether there was an opportunity to do some, you know, in-film merchandising. And that's when, you know, we ended up doing the Bajrangi Bhaijaan pendant. So that was done by Style Quotient, by our company. And once we saw the response to that, that was so huge. I mean, it was such a... I mean, all of us know that Bajrangi Bhaijaan, fortunately, the movie was also such a big hit, that also the pendant was really a big hit. And that's when then we offered Salman, you know, why restrict ourselves only to a pendant? Why can't we do entire jewelry? And that's how actually Being Human Jewelry came into existence. So thanks to Saurabh and to Salman that, you know, at that point in time, it really happened.
So Jacqueline is the outgoing brand ambassador. Who is the new one who is going to come up? The same. Jacqueline is an outgoing brand ambassador of York.
We'll let you know.
Not yet decided?
No, it's decided, but we are not going to announce it now. Let there be some suspense.
It needs Salman's approval. So once he approves it, we'll announce it. Like I said, you know, this whole thing is, it needs Salman's approval because it's his brand primarily. So there are a lot of things which have been right now spoken about, but once it's confirmed, we'll let you know.
We are going to have exclusive outlets as well, which are going to be much smaller and smaller towns rather than in larger town at this stage. Yes, we are present on styleq.com, you know, which is our own website. At the moment, we are not doing fine jewelry on the marketplace. We are doing the fashion jewelry. We have fashion jewelry as well, which is more of brass jewelry, brass and zinc and copper and all that kind of a jewelry, which is very low end, because again, Salman wanted, you know, everyone to afford it. So that's where we have fashion jewelry, which is between 400 rupees to about 2000 rupees, you know, and that is more for the masses. And that's where, which is there on the online portal, like it's there on Myntra. primarily Myntra, and now we are soon going to be on Amazon as well.
How many stores are you planning? Can I get the numbers?
At the moment, we haven't. We have identified a few cities. We have identified 10 cities at this point in time. So we are in no hurry, actually. We just want to be very careful. Very, very gradually, we want to grow. So those are the 10 cities that we're looking out, which are going to be tier one, tier two towns.
I think we can also add that this fashion jewelry is actually for the e-commerce marketplaces as well as the small kiosk in the malls. It is not part of Bandhan Jewels. Bandhan is all about being human diamond jewelry and being human gold jewelry, plain gold in 18 carat and 22 carat, as well as the gold coins. So that's what we have under being human in Bandhan Jewels.
Planning to increase the portfolio, men is very small.
Yes, we are, for sure. Actually, I think it's more going to be on the fashion jewelry segment, I would say. Not so much in the fine, but yes, even in fine, we are going to increase it. But you know, that's the way the proportion is, actually. Even in fine jewelry, if you study the market, it's less than 5%, you know, which is my men's jewelry. So that's the reality.
Well, I've seen a lot of stalwarts here, but a lot of brands are there, a lot of ideas are there, a lot of designs are there. But I just want to understand what is this Bandhan Jewels whole organization structure is like, company structure, who owns what? Thank you.
Bandhan is, as Saurav was talking about, this company style quotient was started by Saurav. Prasad joined in as a partner in that company and the CEO and the director of that company. Then since we are friends and he definitely saw some strengths in terms of being able to manage the retail network and the business development in terms of building a retail channel for the company. So Saurav invited me to be part of this company. So I was running JLMI as the managing director. So JLMI is a partner. Saurav, so company PN Gadgil is a partner and Prasad Kapre is a partner. So that's what three of us are there. I would not like to get into who owns what percentage because that's not for the public forum. But this company was started by Saurav. Yeah. Style Quotient is the company, which is the joint initiative of three different entities, you can say, which is Saurav through PNG, myself through JLMI and Prasad Kapre.
Hello, everybody. So I see each one of you as a pioneer in the jewelry industry, and you've changed certain things. I've always looked at Faraz jewelry, and I've always been wowed by it. I've followed Saurav a lot because I saw on the bus stand of Indore saying PNG Jewelers, I mean PNG Gadgil, and that's how I know. So same with Hare Krishna. And so my question is not purely in the retail, but more of a tech, because that's where I come from. I want to ask that when you look at brands like Swarovski or, you know, at an international level, people are doing a lot with tech, you know, real-time tech, interesting tech, which is something that I don't see here. And I would like to reach out and tell you what I'm doing. But I want to know your views on how do you think a cool or interesting tech through India or here can change, you know, the whole scenario. So for example, Swarovski did this really cool AR thing, which was real time. And these are the things we don't find here. So I just want to hear your views on the technology that might help the industry to grow.
Thank you for that question. It's a very important one because we are in a generation that is more visual. And that's one of the reasons my presentation to all of you was an audiovisual. Today we live in an age where technology has to work hand in hand with your product. So if you have a great product and you can't reach it to your consumer on time or you can't ship it, the consumer is going to lose interest in that product. And that's where we all are realizing that and coming in with technology. It could be websites, it could be mobile apps, it could be augmented reality. But it's very important. So I'm sure that all the brands here and all of us, I personally am looking into it, and I'm sure all of them are, because going forward, that's the only way. Or you lose a lot of customer sales. You know, you have your offline, but you need your online graphics, you need your online technology to pull your customer into that product.
To add to what Farah was saying is, one is being present on the online. Second is using the technology in the aid of a retail store. So that is something which we are definitely planning. I think we fell short in terms of explaining that.
I send them a legal notice and I get money out of them. When I do get to know people who copy my designs, they do hear from my lawyers, and I have received lots and lots of money out of them. So
how do you track them down is more the concern, you know? How do you track them down?
It's very easy. You live in a digital world, and most of these people upload these pictures, and they don't realize that today, with one click of a button, you have access to anything. And once anything's uploaded, it can't be deleted because it's always in the server. It's always there online. So we track them. I have people who work for me who only do that, who actually track people who copy. So my legal team is very strong, and that's how I get them. Thank you.
Thank you.
And more importantly, I actually take the trouble to copyright all my designs. So it becomes more easier for me to take legal action. So even my monogram is completely copyrighted for any product. If you want to make even a paper design out of it, I can sue you for it. I mean, that's how I do